Hi, I'm Bob Meads, and this is WinCC version 8 tips and tricks number 1. Generate pop-up detail screens using the OpenScreenInPopUp function. If you've been using WinCC, you are probably familiar with the PictureWindow object. And what this object does is it just shows a given WinCC screen. So in this case, this pop-up shows this pump pop-up here. And we can pop this up anytime we like using a script or a direct connect. So if you've been following along in our step-by-step series, we configured the pump object to use a direct connect to show this picture window using the display property. So in runtime, we can just click the pump and we'll see this picture window. The downside of this is I always have to have a picture window object. I have to configure it the way that I want it, put it on the screen, and otherwise just manage it. And if we have a lot of pop-ups, this can get tedious. So the open screen and pop-up function, which we're using here, notice that there are no picture windows on this screen, and we can just generate pop-ups anytime we like directly from a script. We can also have these all pop up at the same time if we want. And this is all done with the open screen and pop-up function. So when using the open screen and pop-up function, you don't have to have a picture window object on the screen. It also works with or without tag prefix, which we also covered in the step-by-step series. You can get a handle to the object in runtime, and so you can customize the window's properties like the title script and things like that. And there is an open screen and pop-up function supported in Visual Basic scripting as well as C scripting. So if you're interested, stay tuned. I'll show you how to do this. So we're going to start in Graphics Designer, and on our overview screen currently, we are using picture windows, and when you click the pump, it just shows this picture window, and it is just showing this pump pop-up PDL. That's this guy right here. And if we take a look at the dynamics, you can see that we're using a tag prefix for this page. So looking at tag management, I do have a structure tag, which has my valve on, valve off, pump off. And if we go look at the tags, you can see I have a blue, green, and red series of these structure tags. And that's what I use to populate this pop-up, depending on what pump you click. So what we want to do is get away from using the picture window and just use a script to show it. That way we don't have all these picture windows. So I'm going to start just, I've made a small demo screen and I've just kind of made it small. I will just go down and grab a button. I'll just make the text red. And in order to change the color, I have to turn off my global color scheme. I'll just make this red. Give it a little bit bigger font, and then I will make the font white so that we can use this. So the idea here is I want to press this button and bring up the red pop-up. So I'll go to the events. I'm going to end up putting a VBS action on this, but before I do that, I need to take a look at this function. So we're going to go to Help, Contents and Index. And if you go to search and just type in faceplate pop-up, we have a couple of topics and you can see we've got the open screen and pop-up method for VBS. We have one for ANSI C. And these are also used in faceplates to create detailed pop-ups for faceplates so that there's some stuff in there. But what I'm going to do is just open up the VBS reference. So we've got our syntax here and we've got some required arguments and then we've got some that are optional. If you look at the parameters, these are listed in order. The screen name is going to be the name of the picture you want to pop up. That's going to be our pop-up PDL. And you also have to give the picture window a name. Now, you're not going to use a picture window object, but what happens is when you call this function, it creates a picture window on the fly. And so you have to give it a unique name. If you are using tag prefix, you're going to give it that tag prefix, or you can leave it blank. And then we've got the left and top. So you can define where this pop-up pops up with relation of the object that called it rather than just any coordinates on the screen. And so if you specify a value for these two, then it is going to basically calculate whatever value you put in there away from the middle of this. And it was a little confusing until I figured it out. And if you just want the corner to pop up in the middle of the object, then you leave it empty and you can see that it says, okay, the position, middle position dot X, middle position dot Y. And that means the corner of this pop-up is going to show up near the middle of that object. And you'll see as we do this example what that means. And then you can also specify, is there a close button? Do you need a title bar? And then you have close if open. And so once you call this function, if the picture window, and it looks at it by name, if that picture window is not showing, it will show. And if it is showing, it will turn it off. So it just kind of toggles. And then they give you kind of a quick example of code that you can use. But we're just going to copy this syntax here. So I'll just select the button and I will put a VBS action on the release left. And I'm just gonna paste in the definition. This will make it kind of an easy reference and I'll comment it out. Looking back at the help, using this function, we have to use the set command when we're setting a variable to this because it's returning a reference. If you don't do that, then you're not gonna be able to set some of the properties. And so I'll just do dempw, and you can declare and set on one line if you use a colon. And I'll just set pw equal. And if we do right click properties and methods, you can find the function in here, open screen and pop up. But it doesn't give us the IntelliSense, so I'm hoping that's kind of coming. But the first thing is the screen name. And I'll just put a pair of double quotes because it's a string. We can use our picture selection dialog and just pick our pump pop-up. That's what picture we want to see in our picture window. And then the next thing is your picture window name. So this function is actually going to create a picture window on the fly that's disposable, and we have to give it a unique name. So I'm just going to call this red PW for picture window. And then I'll put a comma, and the next thing is our tag prefix. Well, looking back at our tags are just red, green, and blue with the first letter capitalized. And so since this is red, my tag prefix is going to be red. You got to capitalize that. The left and top, I don't have to put in now. If I don't put anything in there, it's just going to put the upper left-hand corner of the picture window that pops up in the middle of the object. And I don't have to put in the close button title bar. It just assumes you want all this if you don't put anything. And so I can just close out my parentheses here. Let's just see what that gets us. So I'll just click OK. Save. And we'll go to runtime. So if I click the button, notice that the upper left-hand corner's in the middle of this object. That's because we didn't tell it where to be. The other thing I want is a title. I want this to say red pump. You know, that's not very helpful if we don't have a title and I've got several of these things. I don't really know which one it's looking at. So let's go fix that. Go back to our script. So if we want to make changes to the window, like set the title bar text, it doesn't explicitly say it in the help file, but this variable that we use the set command with is actually a handle to the new picture window named red PW. It is showing this picture and the tag prefix is set to this. So if we want to set our title, I can just say set title text PW dot. The caption text is the property that defines the text that is in the text label of the window. And I could just do something like red pump for now. And as far as our coordinates left and top, if I were to just put zeros in there, it would do the same thing as if I left them blank. These are the coordinates of the exact middle of the object, both in the X and Y direction. So if I wanted to move the window, then I could go in and say add 65 pixels. So this isn't position 65 on the screen. It is 65 pixels to the right of the exact middle in the X direction of this object. And we're just going to leave the X direction at 0. And we'll click OK. We'll hit save and go to run. So now we have a title, red pump, and our object is now 65 pixels over in this direction. And you could also calculate and try to match this up. So now let's go add our other buttons. I'll go back to Graphics Designer. And before I do this, I want to make this script a little bit more reusable. We have red, green, and blue. And you can see I've hard-coded red in here for the tag prefix, for the name of the object, and for the title text. but I can really get this just from the text of the button. So as long as I follow that with my green and blue buttons, I've got a handy way to do that. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to create a variable. I can use item, which is really just a handle to this button, and that's pretty handy. So I can just go down and find my text property. And that is the button text, so I'll just put a comment here. And so in this case, on this particular button, the value of my color is going to be red, and then you'll have blue and green. So now I can just go replace that here, there, and also there. So for this button, if this is red, then this is going to be red underscore PW for picture window. My tag prefix will be red, and my caption text will be red pump. So I'll just click OK here, save this, and then let's just go make sure we haven't messed anything up. Oh, we got our red pump, and so it looks like it's still working there. So we will go back and just duplicate our buttons. This will be our green button. This will be our blue button. I will just go here, and I just have to name these the same as my structure instances that I'm using. So we use our capital G green, capital B blue, and looking back at our tags, here's our structure tags. So that looks good. We should just be able to go right to runtime. Here's our red pump. There's our green pump. There's our blue pump. So we didn't have to go change the code. We just had to change the text on the button. Okay, that's what I got for you today. Thanks for watching. Be sure to like this channel and subscribe for new training tips and tricks and how-to videos on Siemens WinCC. Hope to hear from you soon.